In this lesson today, you're going to learn about the different properties of light, and we're going to look at two in particular. So the learning intention is that you will understand that light always travels in straight lines and that it can be reflected off different surfaces. So by the end of this lesson, hopefully you will be able to recall that light travels in straight lines, you'll be able to define reflection and label a diagram showing the reflection of light, and you'll be able to explain the relationship between the angle of incidence and the angle of reflection. One of the most important properties of light is that light will travel in straight lines. Light will always travel in straight lines and will keep traveling in straight lines until it hits something else where it might be absorbed or reflected or refracted. Your own shadow is evidence of this. So light is traveling in a straight line, and then when it hits your body, it's blocking the light and therefore a shadow is created. We can see another example of light traveling in straight lines here. So here I've got the ray box, and whether we use the single slit card or the triple slit card, we can see that the light is traveling in three nice neat lines. So they're not wavy lines, the light's not moving around, it is traveling in a straight line. So now let's have a look at the property of light called reflection. So reflection is the bouncing back of light without absorbing it. So a material can reflect light, causing the light to bounce back from the surface without the surface absorbing it. All right, so now I'm going to show you what happens when light is reflected and how we draw our diagrams in science when we are looking at the way that light behaves. So you can see I've got my light box, I've got my single slit card letting one beam of light through, and here I have a mirror. So I'm going to see how the light behaves when it hits the mirror. So immediately as I put it down, you can see that the light is being reflected off the mirror. And as I move that mirror around, the angle at which that ray is reflected changes. And so we're going to have a look at the relationship between the incident ray. Now the incident ray is the ray that is coming from the light box towards the mirror, and the reflected ray is the one that is reflected off the mirror. So what we do first is we draw a line. So we just trace across the front of our light box so we know where the light box actually was. And I just put a little line or a little dot where that incident ray is starting from. In the same way, let's move it up here. I'm going to put a line across the front of my mirror, and I'm going to again put a little dot where the incident ray hits the mirror and a little dot where the reflected ray comes out. And then again, just further up the line there, just so we can see what's happening, I'm going to put another dot where the reflected ray comes out there. All right, now that we've got all those parts, I can move my equipment out of the way. And it's important that we label each of the parts of this. So over here, we started with our light source. And I'm going to rule a line from where the incident ray started to where it hit the mirror. And it's really important that I put a little arrow on that line to show the direction that the light ray was traveling. So it was traveling from the light box towards the mirror. So we'll label our mirror. You might also see the mirrors written like this, just to show that that's a mirror. Now the reflected ray, same thing, I'm gonna line it up, draw a line, and again, add that arrow to show the direction that the reflected ray was coming out. So this is our incident ray, and this is our reflected ray. A question you might have is why these two lines here don't actually meet properly. It's because where the mirror part of the object actually is. So you can see here's the mirror. The actual mirror part, I'm trying to show you so it's clear, is actually at the back there. Okay, so it's actually gonna hit about here. That's why when we actually do it, there's a little bit of a gap, because the point at which they meet is a little bit further behind where the glass is there. All right, so now let's have a look at the relationship between the incident ray and the reflected ray. What we do now is we
on that point where they would meet, or in between those two parts there. So if we put it on the line, we line it up in between. We're going to find the normal to the mirror. Okay, so the normal is at 90 degrees. So you might know that term from maths. So the normal is 90 degrees to the surface that it's reflecting from. Okay, I'm going to do this as a dotted line. So we know that it's not one of our incident or reflected rays. And I'm going to label it as the normal. So it's at 90 degrees to the mirror. Now I'm going to measure the angle of the incident ray that it makes with the normal. Okay, and here I can see that this angle here, from here to here, is 40 degrees. And I'm also going to measure the angle using a protractor of the reflected ray from the normal. And again, you can see that it is 40 degrees. So the angle of incidence, that's what we call this angle here, is called the angle of incidence, is equal to the angle of reflection. And there you have a diagram showing all parts of that learning. So you've got your light source, the incident ray hitting the mirror, where that ray is reflected from the mirror, and you can see from the angle of incidence, which is the angle between the incident ray and the normal, and the angle of reflection, which is between the reflected ray and the normal, that they are equal.